more than 20,000 homes were left without electricity at the peak of a power cut last night as 90 miles per hour gusts battered Northern Ireland. The Met Office issued an amber warning as Storm Eleanor lashed the region with strong winds. Scores of trees fell, blocking many roads, prompting police to issue a warning not to travel unless absolutely necessary. Storm Eleanor tears roof off Harland and Wolff factory building. Northern Ireland traffic alerts, roads blocked, ferries cancelled and bridge closed. Gusts of up to 90 miles per hour were recorded at Orlochhead in Coe Down. Around 12,000 homes were without electricity due to damage caused by Storm Eleanor last night. Earlier, 21,000 homes had no power. As of 9 p.m. on Wednesday, there were less than 1,000 homes and businesses without power. Julia Carson, NIE Network's communications manager, said that although there has been damage to the network, the repair process is progressing well. But she warned that due to the extent of the damage, some people in the worst affected areas in the southeast, mainly Newry, Ards Peninsula, Armagh and Downpatrick areas, may be without power overnight. Ms. Carson said, "We would like to remind customers that if they do lose electricity supplies, they should report the fault online at nienetworks.co.uk or call our customer helpline on 03457 643 643. Put safety first, and if you do see any trees down across power lines or broken electricity poles, keep away and call NIE Networks immediately. It is likely that some customers will be without power overnight as we respond to over 200 incidences of damage to the network. Our staff will continue to do everything possible to restore power as quickly and safely as possible. Our local incident centers in the worst affected areas are continuing to coordinate the local repair effort, and we have brought in additional call agents to answer customer queries." Ulster Unionist MLA John Stewart was caught up in the storm and tweeted a picture after the rear window of his car was smashed due to flying roof tiles. Mr. Stewart, who lives in Carrickfergus, said, "Tiles came off the roof and landed straight on top of my windshield and did some serious damage to the bodywork and the window. Had it hit someone, there is no doubt it would have killed them. It was three big massive blocks, so thankfully it was just the window, and we can worry about that in the morning. If it had have been myself, one of my kids or a neighbor in the line of fire, you can see what it would have done to somebody's head." Meanwhile, all three of last night's Danske Bank Premiership fixtures were abandoned due to the weather. Parts of the Standard Bank Fuels Arena was evacuated following reports of damage. Coe Fermanagh was reportedly the worst affected area, with scores of fallen trees blocking roads. There were more than 20 trees lying on the Ballyconnell Road near Derry Lynn. It is expected that Eleanor will bring more strong to gale force westerly winds and showers to Northern Ireland today, with a yellow weather warning in place until tea time. The temperature will be a maximum of 8°C. The yellow weather warning is also in force from the northeast and West England and parts of Scotland, with exposed areas set to suffer the worst conditions. The Met Office issued several national severe weather warnings due to the potential for travel disruption. Passengers are advised to check with transport providers ahead of their journey. Met Office forecaster John Wiley said, "The worst of the rain should have cleared by midnight, but there will be squally showers thereafter, blowing through on strong wind all the way through today. There will be no sign of anything settling before Friday." Earlier yesterday evening, winds reached speeds of up to 70 miles per hour, with counties Armagh and Down and the Belfast area the worst affected. Stormy conditions are expected to rage until the weekend starts. By Saturday and Sunday, it will be calmer but colder, Mr. Wiley added. Though sunshine has been forecast for the weekend, temperatures will drop to 5°C, dipping to freezing point tonight. Mr. Wiley said early morning commuters could be faced with debris and surface water on the province's roads and possibly some disruption to transport. High waves can be expected along the North Antrim coast today. Pedestrians are urged to take extreme care on coastal paths and promenades, and not to put themselves in unnecessarily danger trying to take storm selfies. Traffic Watch NI has advised of heavy rain across the north and west, causing some mostly localized road flooding with runoff from now saturated ground. The Department of Infrastructure is reminding motorists to take extra care if severe gales continue, to slow down and keep well back from the vehicle in front. Motorists must also be prepared for debris and obstructions in the road and are reminded that strong wind can blow vehicles, cyclists and pedestrians off course. Flooding hit Galway City, Salt Hill, Oranmore and Clarenbridge as high tides combined with gales during rush hour. In Galway, streets around the docks were flooded after high tides breached defences and inundated streets. Water was more than 1 foot deep in places. Twitter list by Beltel Emergency Contacts, Northern Ireland Electricity Networks 03457-643-643, NIGAS Emergency Service 0800-002-001 Northern Ireland Water Waterline 03457-44-0088 Flooding Incident Line 0300-2100 Housing Executive 03448-920-901 NIE Networks reminded customers of the precautionary measures to take in the event of a power cut, never approach broken lines or damaged poles, and keep children and animals away. Report damage to NIE Networks on 03457-643-643 and listen to recorded messages carefully. If you are using a generator, be careful where you sight it in case of carbon monoxide poisoning. Turn off electric cookers, ovens, irons, etc. If electricity supply is lost, leave a light switched on so you know when power has been restored. Take extra care if using candles, oil lamps or other naked flames. Test smoke alarms with fresh batteries. Ensure adequate ventilation if using gas heaters. Strong winds advice: keep your property in a well-maintained condition. For example, replace, repair any loose roof tiles, guttering, and so on that could potentially come loose and cause injury or damage to property. Secure loose objects such as ladders, garden furniture, wheelie bins, trampolines, or anything else that could be blown around. Close and securely fasten doors and windows. Park vehicles in a garage if you have one, or keep them clear of buildings, trees, walls, and fences. Make sure you are prepared should there be a power cut. For more information and advice, visit NIDirect Belfast Telegraph.